Oh, next song, Josh. There you go. It would be good for me to know the order of the songs that we're playing.
Oh,
Para los que esta es la primera vez, for those that are the first time, acabe de llegar yo de Bolivia, Juan 17, 6 a 12. John 17, 6 to 12. Acabo de llegar de Bolivia, de una misión que tenemos en que entrenamos pastores. This is the first time here. I was out on a trip to Bolivia, training pastors down there. Por eso yo quiero dar una actualización a la iglesia acá de lo que pasó y todo eso. So I want to give a bit of an update to everybody who was here about how it went. Todo fue muy bien, todo salió muy, muy bien, y tuvimos la oportunidad de entrenar como 25 pastores. We had the opportunity to train about 25 pastors, y 25 mujeres también en los principios de discipulado. We trained women as well, about 25, in the principles of discipleship. Una cosa que pasó cuando lleguemos es que la mujer que era la traductora, o se suponía estar la traductora, averiguamos dos cosas. When we got there, this lady who was supposed to be the translator, we learned two things about her. Primero, a pesar de enseñar inglés en un colegio por 18 años, ella no conocía inglés. Así es. She taught English in a high school for about 18 years, but she didn't really know English that well. So, típicamente cuando vas a usar un traductor, ellos necesitan conocer inglés. Or el lenguaje. If they're going to translate, they typically need to know the language that they're going to use. So that was first. Pero la cosa más importante es que averiguamos que ella no era cristiana. We found out she was not a Christian as well right when we got there. Por tres horas, mientras yo y los otros hermanos estaban cruzando a Brasil y disfrutando el tiempo, las mujeres con nosotros estaban compartiendo el evangelio con ella. So for about 3 hours on Sunday afternoon, while the rest of the guys and I were out cruising around Brazil, hanging out, having fun, the ladies back at the hotel were sharing the gospel with this lady. Y ese día, el primer día en Guayaramirim, ella recibió a Cristo, y después de eso, ella proveyó que su niña sea bautizada en la iglesia de Mormón. Así que fue una gran victoria para el evangelio, para Cristo y todo eso, a pesar del hecho que yo traducí y otro hombre traducí todo para la semana, y por eso yo llegué cansado. They shared the gospel with her for 3 hours when they got there on Sunday, and she received Christ the first day we were there, and after that she sat in her training all week, and she kept her daughter from being baptized in the Mormon church the very next week. So it was a great victory for the gospel, and despite the fact that, you know, the translation was then very difficult after that. But it was a great week. Gracias por las oraciones, y extrañé a mi familia de la iglesia, y estoy agradecido de estar acá con ustedes. I missed all of you guys, and I'm really glad to be here with you. So thank the Lord for getting us back and for having a great trip. So si tienes la Biblia, de nuevo, Juan 17, 6 a 12, John 17, 6 to 12, who can read that for us? ¿Quién puede leer? Benjamín and Phil. Benjamín and Phil. Okay, Ben.
Jesús ora por sus discípulos. A los que me diste del mundo les he revelado quién eres. Eran tuyos, tú me los diste y ellos han obedecido tu palabra. Ahora saben que todo lo que me has dado viene de ti, porque les he entregado las palabras que me diste y ellos las aceptaron. Saben con certeza que salí de ti y han creído que tú me enviaste. Ruego por ellos, no ruego por el mundo, sino por los que me has dado, porque son tuyos. Todo lo que yo tengo es tuyo y todo lo que tú tienes es mío. Y por medio de ellos he sido glorificado. Ya no voy a estar por más tiempo en el mundo, pero ellos están todavía en el mundo y yo vuelvo a ti. Padre Santo, protégelos con el poder de tu nombre, en el nombre que me diste, para que sean unos, los mismos que nosotros. Mientras estaba con ellos, los protegía y los preservaba mediante el nombre que me diste. Y ninguno se perdió, sino aquel que nació para perderse, a fin de que se cumpliera la Escritura.
I have manifested your name to the people whom you gave me out of the world. Yours they were, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything that you have given me is from you, for I have given them the words that you gave me. They have rejoiced, and they have received them, and have come to know the truth, know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am praying for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those who you have given me, for they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine. And I am glorified in them, and I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, keep them in your name, which you have given me, that they may be one, even as we are one.
Cuando lleguemos a Juan 17, lleguemos a una de las partes, en mi opinión, más preciosas de toda la Escritura.
When we come to John 17, I think we come to one of the most precious parts, at least in my opinion, in all of the Bible.
Porque tenemos en Juan 17 una ventana por medio de la cual podemos entrar y ver la comunión de la Trinidad.
What we have in John 17 is a window through which you can see the communion of the Trinity.
Tú tienes una invitación en Juan 17. Una invitación diferente de lo que tú tienes en toda la otra de la Escritura, para entrar en la unidad y la comunidad de la Trinidad en que Jesús está hablando en alta voz, para que escuchemos, para saber lo que ha estado pasando desde la eternidad pasada.
What you have is an invitation to come in and listen to now Jesus talking out loud so that you can hear him, so that you know this is the unity of the community and the Trinity that's been happening since eternity past. You don't have this opportunity in all of Scripture.
Tú tienes la oportunidad hoy para entrar aquí. Y para mí, yo creo que para hablar en términos bíblicos, yo creo que esa es Tierra Santa.
To talk in biblical terms now, we're saying this is holy ground.
Y para entrar, como Moisés, hay que quitar las sandalias.
You need to take off your shoes right here.
Tú necesitas entrar con reverencia porque Jesús está hablando con su Padre.
Acepta de ti. Jesus is talking to his Father now. Take your shoes off. This is just like Moses in the burning bush. And you need to be reverent here because this is God himself talking to himself.
So it's Dios el mismo, hablando a Dios el mismo. Por eso, es una parte de la Biblia preciosa. Pero más que eso, it's more than that. Listen to me close now. Esa parte de la Biblia se llama la oración intercesora.
This is a part of the Bible that's called the high priestly prayer.
¿Por qué? Porque Jesús, exactamente como el sumo sacerdote, entró en el lugar santísimo.
This is Jesus, just like the high priest who entered in, not the other priest, the high priest who entered into the holy place once a year.
¿Qué tenía cuando entró en el lugar santísimo? What did he have when he went in?
Blood.
Siempre con sangre. Tú puedes imaginar, tú tienes la cortina acá, tú tienes el altar acá, y adentro tú tienes el arca del pacto.
Right here you've got the curtain, you've got a golden altar, and inside you've got the Ark of the Covenant.
Aquí es el sumo sacerdote con las brasas calientes en su palio, con sangre sobre, así.
You can see him, he's entering the room now, he's got hot coals, a shovel, and blood on top, and he's entering into the holy place like this. Why?
¿Por qué? Porque está entrando así. Porque la primera cosa que Dios necesita ver adentro del lugar santísimo es que sangre.
The first thing God has to see when he enters into that holy place is blood. Otherwise, he's dead. Immediately.
Aquí el sumo sacerdote está adentro del lugar santísimo con sangre, intercediendo a Dios por la gente que está alrededor del tabernáculo para aplacar la ira de Dios al vivir su pecado. Here's the high priest who's in the holy place, and he's got blood, and he's interceding to God to placate the wrath of God that exists against all these people that are around the tabernacle, all the people of Israel. Y tú puedes imaginar en ese momento que Jesús, con los discípulos alrededor y todos los santos de todas las épocas, él está intercediendo a Dios porque está en punto de derramar su sangre por ellos en el trono real. Here's Jesus with the disciples around him and every saint that will ever believe through their word. They're all around him, and Jesus is standing before God interceding for you, because he's at the point of going to shed his blood and be massacred and slaughtered on the cross, and he's going to go to heaven and offer it on the throne, the real throne. ¿Sabes qué? Si quieres saber lo que Jesús está haciendo ahora mismo, él está en la diestra del Padre intercediendo por todas las ovejas. If you want to know what's Jesus doing right now, he's sitting at the Father's side, interceding for all of the sheep. That's what he's doing. Listen to Hebrews 7:25. Mira a Hebreos 7:25. Por eso también puede salvar por completo. Therefore, he is able to save to the uttermost a los que por medio de él se acercan a Dios, ya que vive siempre para interceder por ellos. Because he ever lives, listen, he ever lives to make intercession for them. What is Jesus doing right now? ¿Qué está haciendo Jesús a la diestra del Padre intercediendo por mí? Mire, escúchame bien. Si eres cristiano en este cuarto de esta mañana, if you're a Christian here this morning, la única razón que vas a llegar sin mancha y sin caerse es porque Jesús está intercediendo a la diestra del Padre. The only reason, if you're a Christian, that you will make it there, it is not because you're good, nor because you are intelligent. It's because Jesus is interceding for you at the right hand of the Father. If he wasn't doing that, you're dead. You won't make it. You will stop believing. Y eso es el punto de este texto. That's the point of this text. Mira, tú puedes imaginar el contexto aquí, ¿no? You can just imagine the context here. Jesús, en el pasaje que Ben predicaba, this is in the passage that Ben preached 2 weeks ago. Jesús dijo esto. Here's what Jesus said to the disciples. You can just imagine this outside the upper room. Es fuera del aposento alto. Jesús estaba hablando a los discípulos y él dijo esto. Miren que la hora viene. Look, the time is coming. Y hasta aquí que ustedes serán dispersados y cada uno se irá a su propia casa y a mí me dejarán solo. He says, the time is coming when you're all going to be dispersed, you're all going to go to your own house, and you're going to leave me what? Alone. Mira, ¿quién ha salido del grupo justo antes de eso? Who left the group just before this? Judas. Judas just left the group. ¿Puedes imaginar que los discípulos, ellos están pensando cuando oyen eso de Jesús? ¿Yo voy a hacer lo que él hizo? I think they might be asking themselves in this moment, am I going to do what Judas did? ¿Yo voy a abandonar como Judas? Am I going to abandon you like Judas did? ¿A perdición? Am I going to go die just like he did? Is that what I'm going to be doing? Yo creo que esa oración es para contestar esa pregunta. Mira, aquí, para nosotros, escúchame bien. If you're a Christian, just listen to me very closely. ¿Cómo es que tú vas a llegar al cielo? Con todas las amenazas a tu fe, con toda la tentación de pecado, ¿cómo es que tú vas a llegar sin mancha? How is it, Christian, with in this world, with all of the temptation, all the threat to your faith, that you're going to arrive there? How is that? You think that you can do it just because, I'll just keep believing, will you? ¿Cómo es posible que tú vas a llegar allá? Mira, la respuesta a la duda de los discípulos, la respuesta para nosotros, es saber lo que Jesús está diciendo aquí. Aquí es la respuesta. Here's the answer that Jesus gives you, Christian. This is why you'll make it. Él no te perderá porque siempre ha sido suya. Suyo. He's not going to lose you because you've always been his. Él no te puede perder porque siempre has pertenecido a él y siempre serás suyo. Y por eso él está orando para guardarte. Eso es porque vas a llegar. You're going to make it because you've always been his, and you always will be his, and he's praying for you to keep you in the faith. That's the only reason you'll make it. Listen, we need to be
be a church that says, we're not awesome. We just got a great Jesus who's praying for me. Necesitamos ser una iglesia que dice, mira, no somos impresionantes. No somos nada. Pero tenemos un Salvador que está orando por nosotros y por eso yo puedo llegar. So the only reason I'm going to make it, folks, the only reason you're going to make it is because Jesus is praying for you. Now here's the great thing. Él dijo en Juan 17:11. Look at John 17:11. Padre Santo, guárdalos en tu nombre. He says, Holy Father, keep them in your name. El nombre que me has dado, the name you've given me. Para que sean uno, así como nosotros, so that they will be one, just like us. Aquí la cosa. In 6 a 12, in versículos 6 a 12, Jesús está orando específicamente por los discípulos. In 6 to 12, Jesus is praying specifically for the disciples. Pero ¿sabes qué? Después de eso, Él está orando por cada persona que creerían en Jesús por medio de su palabra. Eso incluye, ¿qué? Nosotros. Jesus is praying in 6 to 12 for the disciples, and then after that, He's praying for everybody who will believe through their word. So guess who's included in that? You, if you believe. Listen to what He says here in John 17:20. It's 1:17-20. Mas no ruego solo por estos, sino también por los que han de creer en mí por la palabra de Dios. I'm not praying just for them, the disciples. I'm also praying for everyone who will believe through their word. Mira, esta mañana, si crees en Jesús, si realmente eres una oveja de Jesús, tú necesitas saber y dar cuenta que Jesús estaba orando por ti, específicamente hace 2,000 años, la noche antes de su crucifixión. This is what you need to know if you're a Christian in the room today. If you are a sheep, a real sheep, you need to know that 2,000 years ago, Jesus was praying for you the night before He was slaughtered. And He was praying that you would be kept. And because He prayed that, you're still a Christian. Without that, you wouldn't be. Eso es el punto. Guárdalos, Padre. Eso es el punto. Tú necesitas saber, cristiano, porque, bueno, lo que pasa con los cristianos muchas veces, lo que pasó en mi vida, es que lleguemos a ser salvos, pero realmente no sabemos de lo que pasó a nosotros. What happens to us a lot of times, and listen to me very closely here, because this is, I just find this to be true of myself and others. You come to get saved, you come to receive Christ, but really you don't know what happened to you. No sabes lo que pasó, realmente. In plenitude. Tú no sabes. You don't know exactly what happened in all of the fullness. And Jesus is telling you here, here's how you got saved, and here's how you'll get to heaven. Eso es como llegas a ser salvo, y como vas a ser salvo para siempre. ¿Cómo es? Bueno, buena pregunta. Me alegra que hayas preguntado. Gracias, Ben, por la pregunta. Okay, so thanks for the question. Here we go. All right, so how is it I got saved, and how is it that He's keeping me? So here's what I want you to see. Two things, the revelation of God to us and the prayer of God for us. La revelación de Dios a nosotros, la primera cosa que yo quiero que veas, y la segunda cosa es la oración de Dios por nosotros. Primero, la revelación de Dios a nosotros. So, the revelation of God to us. La obra de Cristo. Él dice en Juan 17:6, John 17:6, he manifestado tu nombre a los hombres que el mundo me dice. I have revealed or manifested your name to the men that you gave me. Now, manifestar el nombre. El nombre significa en la cultura judía, él significa la persona. To say the name in Jewish culture just meant the person. Para decir el nombre significa el carácter de una persona. Por eso, cuando Jesús dijo, yo he manifestado tu nombre, él está diciendo, yo he manifestado tu carácter. When Jesus says, I manifested your name to them, name in the Bible tends to do with, and not probably not comprehensively, but tends to do with the character of a person. So when He says, I revealed you, or your name, He's saying, I revealed God to you. Cuando Jesús actuó, Dios actuó. Cuando Jesús habló, Dios habló. Cuando Jesús hizo algo, Dios hizo it. ¿Me entiendes? When Jesus said something, God spoke. When Jesus did something, God did it. When Jesus performed a miracle, that was God. Mira, sabemos eso. Porque tenemos pasajes como esto en Juan 14. We know this because we have passages like this in John 14. Listen. Felipe le dijo, Señor, muéstranos al Padre y nos basta. You remember when Philip's talking to Jesus, and he's got a little bit of doubt. Slightly. He says, hey, if you would just show us the Father, that would be sufficient for us. Felipe, Jesús le dijo, tanto tiempo he estado con vosotros y todavía no me conoces, Felipe. He says, how long have I been with you and you still don't know me? Escúchame bien. Listen to this. El que me ha visto a mí, ha visto al Padre. He who has seen me has seen who? The Father.
¿No crees que yo estoy en el Padre y el Padre en mí? Do you not believe that I'm in the Father and the Father is in me? Las palabras que yo os digo, no las hablo por mi propia cuenta. The words that I speak to you don't come from my own account, sino que el Padre que mora en mí es el que hace las obras. But the Father who dwells in me is he who does his works. Mira, sabemos que por medio del libro de Juan, lo que Jesús hizo es revelar al Padre. Eso es lo que él hizo. We know that what Jesus does, this is the whole mission, is to reveal God to you. Escúchame, es una aplicación. Mira, si no te gusta Jesús, no te gusta Dios. If you don't like Jesus, okay? If you don't like Jesus, you don't like God. Period. Porque Jesús es la revelación perfecta de Dios. Jesus is the revelation, perfect revelation of God. So if you don't like him, you don't like God. Now listen to me. Esto es lo que Jesús se refería en Juan 17:4. This is what Jesus was referring to in John 17:4. Listen to this. Yo te glorifiqué en la tierra, habiendo terminado la obra que me diste que hiciera. He says in John 17:4, I glorified you on the earth, having accomplished the work which you gave me to do. ¿Cuál obra? La obra de revelar al Padre. Él ha revelado al Padre plenamente. He's saying the work that you gave me to do is to reveal the Father to you. Now he's going to do that even more on the cross. But the work of Jesus, if you want to sum it up, is I came to reveal God to this world. Yo me vine para revelar a Dios a este mundo plenamente, claramente, por siempre. La última revelación de Dios. Jesús. Por eso tenemos pasajes así en Juan 1. This is why you have passages like this in John 1. Listen to this. Juan 1, 14 y 18. John 1, 14 and 18. El verbo se hizo hombre y habitó entre nosotros y hemos contemplado su gloria, la gloria que corresponde al Hijo unigénito del Padre. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, glories of the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. Nadie, this is 18, this is 18, nadie ha visto jamás a Dios, el unigénito Dios, que está en el seno del Padre, Él le ha dado a conocer. This is John 1:18. Nobody's seen the Father at any time. The only begotten God who is in the bosom of the Father, He has revealed Him. Mira, algo que necesitamos recordar, ¿ok? Hay que recordar eso. Jesús vino para qué?
Para
revelar al Padre, para salvarnos. Bueno, Jesus came to
redeem.
Reveal the Father. Thank you. All right. Jesus came to reveal the Father. Okay. Para revelar al Padre. Okay. Eso es algo bien importante que necesitamos recordar. That's something pretty important that you need to remember. Now, aquí es la cosa importante de ese versículo. Here's something very important and interesting about this verse. Look what he said. He manifestado tu nombre a los hombres del mundo que me diste. I revealed your name to who? What's the passage say? He manifestado tu nombre a los que me has dado. I revealed your name to those whom you've given. Pare y pensar. Just stop and think for a second. Hay una revelación de cierta forma en que Jesús reveló al Padre al mundo generalmente. There is a way in which Jesus reveals God to the world generally. Pero eso es no a qué se refería aquí. That's not what he's talking about right here. Hay una revelación especial de la palabra a los discípulos y a cada oveja en que Jesús revela al Padre específicamente, personalmente, íntimamente, que es diferente que el mundo. There is a way that Jesus, with his disciples and everybody else who would believe, in which he reveals the Father to them personally, intimately, and specifically. Listen, if the only thing you know of Jesus is just this general revelation, you don't know him. Jesús está diciendo esto. He manifestado tu nombre específicamente a los hombres que del mundo me diste. I have revealed your name to them. How? Specially. Mira, escúchame bien. Bueno, ¿tú recuerdas cuando Ben estaba predicando? You remember when Ben was preaching? Y él dijo algo de Juan 16:25. He said something from John 16:25. Listen to this. Les he dicho todo esto por medio de comparaciones. I've told you all of this in figurative language. Pero viene la hora en que ya no les hablaré así, sino que les hablaré claramente acerca de mi Padre. But the time is coming when I'm not going to talk to you in figurative language, I'm going to talk to you clearly about my Father. Bueno, él solo estaba hablando a los discípulos. He was only talking to the disciples. Él dice, es un privilegio que ustedes tienen que yo voy a hablar claramente acerca del Padre a ustedes. He says, you all have a privilege. Okay? If you're saved in this room, you have a privilege. God came to you and spoke clearly, personally, specifically, and intimately about the Father. Y la única razón, escúchame, la única razón que tú has creído y en este momento todavía crees es porque Dios ha comunicado por medio del Espíritu Santo su palabra específicamente a tu corazón. Let me tell you what happened to Ben. Okay? Let me tell you what happened to Ben. I'm going to use Ben as an example. He should stop sitting right here because he always ends up being my example. All right? Siempre es mi ejemplo porque se sienta acá. Está bien. Eso es lo que pasó a Ben. This is what happened. Un día, cuando estábamos estudiando la palabra, when we were studying the word, right? El Espíritu Santo vino con la palabra que probablemente él había oído antes. The Spirit came with a word that probably he had heard before. Probablemente él había oído la palabra de Dios muchísimas veces y el Evangelio también. Probably he had heard the gospel and the word of God many, many times and all of this. Do you know what happened that day? El Espíritu Santo vino, abrió su corazón. Puso el Espíritu Santo y la palabra de Dios adentro de tu corazón. En ese momento, él vivía por la primera vez. God came. He took the word of God, opened Ben's heart, and shoved it in there for the first time, personally, specifically, and intimately, and Ben lived for the first time in his life. That's what happened. With a word he had heard before. Eso es lo que pasa con las ovejas. Eso es lo que pasa con los cristianos. Mira, para mí, 20 años después de oír la palabra cada semana. For me, it happened 20 years after I'd heard the word every single week. And God came one day, and he opened my heart. That's what he's saying here. Yo he revelado tu nombre, yo he manifestado tu nombre a los que del mundo me dice. Now listen to this. This is 1 Corinthians 2, 12-13. This is la primera de Corintios 2, 12-13. Escúchame bien, bien importante ese versículo. Jonathan, can you look this one up and read it? 1 Corinthians 2, 12-13. Nosotros no hemos recibido el Espíritu del mundo, sino el Espíritu que procede de Dios para que entendamos lo que por su gracia Él nos ha concedido. Esto es precisamente de lo que hablamos, no con las palabras que enseña la sabiduría humana, sino con las que enseña el Espíritu, de modo que expresamos verdades espirituales en términos espirituales. Eso es decir, la única razón que yo entiendo lo que la Biblia dice es porque el Espíritu Santo abrió mi corazón y habló a mí, claramente, personalmente, específicamente. John, read it real quick, will you?
Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, so that we can know the things freely given to us by God, which things we also speak, not in words taught by human wisdom, but in those taught by the Spirit, combining spiritual thoughts with spiritual words.
Look, the only reason that if you take this Bible right now, and it's not just like a newspaper to you, if you take this Bible and you understand anything about it, it is because the Spirit of God opened your heart to understand it. Because without Him, you would read this and you would go, not interested. That's what happened to some of y'all this morning. Eso es lo que pasó a algunos de ustedes esta mañana. Tú estás tratando de leer la Biblia y tú estás como, oh, Espíritu Santo, bien para abrir mi corazón. Yo necesito ver algo en la Biblia. God, come, open my heart, help me see. That's what happened. Mira, Jesús dice, yo he manifestado tu nombre a los hombres del mundo me diste específicamente. I came to reveal your name to these men specifically. This was the mission of Jesus. And not just to them, but to everybody who would learn from them. No solo a ellos, pero a todos que aprenderían de su palabra. Now, escúchame, yo quiero saber por qué ellos. ¿Y por qué tú, cristiano? Why, Philip? Why him? Escúchame. Look, listen to John 17:6 again. Mira Juan 17:6 de nuevo. He manifestado tu nombre a los hombres que del mundo me diste. Esa es la frase. Eran tuyos. I have revealed your name to those from the world that you have given me.
though they were yours. When? Cuando. Eran tuyos cuando. Pertenecían a Dios cuando. When were they his? Listen to this from Ephesians 1, 4 and 6. It's Ephesians 1, 4 and 6. Dios nos escogió en él antes de la creación del mundo. God chose us in him, Christ, before the foundation of the world. Listen. Para que seamos santos y sin mancha delante de él, so that we would be holy and blameless before him. En amor nos predestinó para ser adoptados como hijos suyos por medio de Jesucristo. In love, he predestined us to be adopted as sons through Jesus Christ. ¿Cuándo es que yo pertenecía a Dios antes de la creación del mundo? En la eternidad pasada. When did I belong to him? Before the world was made. He chose me. Put me in Christ. Saw me through the cross. That's what happened to me. I didn't know that when I got saved. Yo no sabía de eso. No me di cuenta de eso cuando yo recibí a Cristo por la primera vez. Pero yo me di cuenta de lo que pasó a mí por medio de leer la Biblia. Y Jesús me dijo, mira, siempre has pertenecido a Él. You've always belonged to Him. He was coming for you. That's what happened to you, Christian. Mira, cuando Él dice, he manifestado tu nombre a los hombres que del mundo. When He says, I've revealed your name to those from the world, es la misma construcción griega que Jesús usaba en Juan 15 y 19. It's the same construction, listen to this now, in the original that Jesus used in John 15, 19. When He says this, si fueran del mundo, el mundo los amaría como los suyos. If you were of the world would love you as your own. Now watch this. Pero ustedes no son del mundo, sino que yo los he escogido de entre el mundo. But you are not of the world, but I have chosen you from the world. Para usar bien, de nuevo, como ejemplo, eso es lo que pasó con él. Él creyó, Dios lo salvó de su vida de pecado. Pero en los ojos de Dios, bien pertenecía a él antes de la creación. Now, Jesus came and saved Ben from the life of sin and vanity that he was living in. But can I tell you something? God knew him before the foundation of the world. No solo eso. Jesús dijo en Juan 17, 10. This is John 17, 10. Listen to this. Todo lo mío es tuyo y lo tuyo mío. He says, everything that's mine is yours and everything that's yours is mine. Eso significa que yo siempre he pertenecido a Dios, siempre he pertenecido a Jesús. This means that if everything that is Jesus is God's and God's is Jesus, then if I belong to God from the foundation of the world, then I've always belonged to Jesus. Now here's the great part, okay? That's great. Eso es increíble. Pero aquí es la parte más increíble. Él dijo, eran tuyos, Juan 17, 6. He says, they were yours, John 17, 6, but watch this. Y me los diste, and you gave them to me. ¿Sabes qué? Yo puedo usar algo más. Joy. Okay. Joy era un regalo del padre al hijo. Un regalo de amor. Joy was a gift from God to the Son. Eran tuyos y me los diste. They were yours and you gave them to me. Like a gift. Dios, antes de la creación del mundo, en la eternidad pasada, yo creo, estaba hablando con su hijo tal vez, y él dijo, mira, yo voy a dar Joy como un regalo de amor a ti. I'm going to give her, God says to Jesus, before the earth was founded, I'm going to give her as a love gift to you. Your reward is my joy, but guess what? You get her. And I'm going to give her to you. Es increíble a pensar que el propósito de tu vida realmente es ser un regalo de amor a Jesús. It's really interesting and it provides a lot of purpose for your life. If you start thinking, you know what? God gave me to Jesus as a love gift. That's the purpose of my life. And that happened before you were even thought of. Eso pasó antes de la creación del mundo, antes de alguien concedió de ti. Bueno, dice, In Juan 6:37, hemos visto este concepto antes en el libro de Juan. We've seen this before in the book of John. Listen to this. Todos los que el Padre me da vendrán a mí, y al que a mí viene no lo rechazo. Jesus says, everything that the Father, or everything that belongs to the Father, they'll come to me. Once he's given me, they're going to come, and he who comes, I will never cast out. Escúchame bien, cristiano, eso es porque crees. This is why you believe, Christian. Mira, eso es la cadena. Dios te escogió antes de la creación del mundo, te dio a Cristo, Cristo reveló personalmente la palabra de Dios, y por eso ahora estás creyendo. This is the chain that happened to you. God chose you before the foundation of the world. Jesus came, and God gave you to Jesus. Jesus came and revealed the Word personally to you, and that's why you believe, and that's why you'll continue to believe. You've always been His, Christian. Siempre has sido suyo. Siempre has pertenecido a Él. You've always belonged to Him. That's something we need to celebrate and not hide from. Si todo eso ha pasado, de Juan 6:45 es, tiene que ver con su vida. This is John 6:45. If all that's happened to you, then this is true of you. Listen to this. En los profetas está escrito, in the prophets is written, a todos los instruirá Dios. God will instruct all of them. En efecto, todo el que escucha al Padre y aprende de él viene de mí. Everyone who's heard from the Father, that's Jesus' revelation. Es la revelación de Jesús de oír al Padre. Todos los que han escuchado al Padre y aprendido de él, vienen a mí. Everyone who's learned from him, heard him, they come to me. Eso es lo que pasó en la vida. Mira, Jesús quiere probar que los discípulos son reales, son realmente los regalos de amor al Hijo. He wants to prove now, he wants to say, you know, to talk about these disciples, they really are the love gifts from the Father to the Son. So he says five things about the disciples. This is important. Él dice cinco cosas acerca de los discípulos para probar que realmente son ovejas que siempre han pertenecido a Dios y que fueron dados al Hijo como regalos de amor. He says these five things to prove that really the disciples have always belonged to God and they always will, and they've been given to the Son. This is what he says. Number one, han guardado tu palabra. Number one, they've kept your word. Segundo, ahora han conocido que todo lo que me has dado viene de ti. They've also known that everything that you've given me comes from you. Porque yo les he dado las palabras que me diste y las recibieron. So they've looked upon you, they've seen the words that you've given me, and they know it's coming from you. And then he says, y las recibieron, they received them, y entendieron, and they understood them, que en verdad salí de ti, that really they came from you, y creyeron que tú me enviaste, and they believed that you sent me. Mira, han guardado tu palabra, han conocido, han recibido, han entendido, y han creído. They kept your word, they knew that I was from you, they received, understood, and believed. Todos los signos de la vida tú puedes ver en el libro de Juan. You can see all these signs of life in the book of John. Listen, si eres cristiano en este cuarto, tú necesitas ver los signos de la vida en tu vida. If you're a Christian in the room, you need to see all five of these in your life. Listen to this. This is just from the book of John. Esto es solo del libro de Juan. Juan 7:17. This is John 7:17. Él dice, el que quiera hacer la voluntad de Dios conocerá. Si la doctrina es de Dios, o si yo hablo por mi propia cuenta, conocerá. Ellos han conocido. He says first, knowing, they know. This is what he says in John 7:17. If anyone's will is to do God's will, he will know whether my teaching is from God or if I speak on my own account. He will know. Do you know? Conoces. Conoces que Jesús es de Dios. Conoces. Con confianza. Do you know with assurance that this is, do you know that? Because this, you will have this sign of life. Tú vas a tener ese signo de la vida, pero también, no solo conocer, not just know, listen to John 1:12. Mas a cuantos lo recibieron, a los que creen en su nombre, les dio el derecho de ser hijos de Dios. More than that, but those who received, those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Primero conocer, first to know, segundo recibir y creer, then you believe and you receive. Have you believed and received him like a treasure? No como un plomero.
Has recibido a Jesús no como alguien que está trabajando por ti, pero después de trabajo tú quieres que vaya. Have you received Jesus like a treasure, not like somebody that you just welcome into your house for a minute, then you kick him out? Have you received him, understood? Listen, this is the last thing. Listen to this. En verdad, es Juan 8:51. This is John 8:51. En verdad os digo que si alguno guarda mi palabra, no verá jamás la muerte. He says, truly, truly, I say to you, if anyone keeps my word, that one will never see death. Keep. Conocer, know. Entender, understand. Recibir, creer, receive and believe. Y después, guardar, to keep. Mira, tú necesitas ver los cinco signos de la vida en la vida si realmente eres oveja. Si no ves, no eres. If you don't see these five signs of life, you're not a Christian. Porque él dice, Jesús dice, para probar que esos discípulos son realmente los regalos de amor que Dios te ha dado, o le ha dado, él dice, mira, yo tengo los cinco signos de la vida, Dios, que tú puedes ver en la vida de ellos para probar que realmente son ovejas. You can see he's saying to prove that these guys really are the love gifts that God gave, that really that they have always belonged to God. Jesus says, look at their life. Five signs of life that you can see in their life. You can tell God that they really are the sheep of God and they really have always belonged to you. Mira. ¿Quién eres, Christian? Who are you, Christian? ¿Eres una persona que siempre has pertenecido a Dios? You're a person that's always belonged to God. ¿Eres una persona que fue dado a Jesús como regalo de amor? You're a person that was given to Jesus as a love gift. ¿Eres una persona que ha recibido la revelación personalmente, íntimamente, específicamente de Jesús? You're a person that's received revelation personally, intimately, and specifically. ¿Y eres una persona que has conocido, has entendido, has recibido, has creído, y es guardando la palabra de Dios? You are a person that has understood, received, known, believed, and is keeping to the present moment the Word of God. And if that's not true of you, then you're not a sheep. Si eso no es la verdad de la vida, no eres oveja. ¿Tú puedes ver la cadena? Can you see this chain? ¿Tú puedes ver? Bueno, si eso es cierto en la vida, see, this, if this has happened in your life, then Jesus' prayer, he's praying, is to keep you. Si eso ha pasado en la vida, la oración de Dios es para guardarte. Y eso es lo que va a pasar. Escúchame bien. Él dice, Juan 17:9-10. This is John 17:9-10. Listen. Yo ruego por ellos, no ruego por el mundo. I'm praying for them. I'm not praying for the world. Esa oración que Dios está orando ahora, que está rogando, no es para el mundo. Es para los discípulos específicamente. This prayer is not just, this is not for the world, this is for the disciples specifically. Because only the disciples and only those who are truly sheep are going to be kept. Esta oración solo es para los discípulos y las ovejas. Escúchame bien, él dice, sino por los que me has dado porque son tuyos. I'm not praying for the world, I'm praying for those you've given me because they're yours. Y todo lo mío es tuyo, y lo tuyo mío, y he sido glorificado en ellos. Everything that's mine is yours, yours is mine, and I've been glorified in them. And then he says, look at verse 11, mira versículo 11. Ya no estoy en el mundo, pero ellos sí están en el mundo. Yo voy a ti. I'm not in the world any longer. They're going to be in the world, and I'm coming to you. Padre Santo, guárdalos en tu nombre, el nombre que me has dado para que sean uno, así como nosotros. Holy Father, guard them in your name. Keep them in your name, the name you've given me, so that they will be one. Listen to me. Este mundo es un lugar peligroso. This is a dangerous place. Hay gente que abandona la fe cada día. There are people that leave the faith every single day. How do you know you're going to make it? ¿Cómo sabes que vas a llegar allá? Es porque Jesús está orando para guardarte. Jesus is praying to keep you. Hay tentaciones de suicidio cada día. There are temptations to commit suicide in your faith every single day and say, I'm done with this. Either it hurts too bad or it's too pleasure to be outside the faith and you say, I'm done with Jesus. Por eso Jesús dice, guárdalos en tu nombre. Keep them in your name. Tú recuerdas un nombre, es una persona. Él dice, más o menos a Dios, guárdalos en tu persona, Dios. Porque ellos están adentro de ti. He says, more or less, keep them in your person. ¿Qué es? ¿Qué es? ¿Qué significa ser cristiano? What does it mean to be a Christian?
significa que tú estás conectado a Cristo y adentro de él. To be a Christian means that you are inside of Jesus, and he's praying right here, keep them in you. Él está orando que guardes adentro de ti, Dios, porque ellos están adentro de ti. Por eso, tú tienes pasajes como Judas 24. This is why you have passages like Jude 24. Listen to this. Phil, can you read this in English? Jude 24. Mira, Judas 24. Al único Dios, nuestro Salvador, que puede guardarlos para que no caigan y establecerlos sin tacha y con gran alegría ante su gloriosa presencia, sea la gloria, la majestad, el dominio y la autoridad por medio de Jesucristo nuestro Señor, antes de todos los siglos, ahora y para siempre. Amén. Read Jude 24, Phil.
Yeah. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to make you stand in the presence of his glory, blameless with great joy.
Ahora a él. Que puede guardarlos. Now to him who is able to keep you. Mira, lo que Jesús está orando aquí es que Dios te guarde adentro de él mismo y protegerte de las tentaciones y las flechas del enemigo y de las tentaciones de salir y de abandonar a Cristo y todo eso. He's saying, God, keep them in you and keep them away from temptation. Keep them free from flaming arrows. Keep them free from temptation to leave and to abandon. Keep them inside of you. Keep them connected. That's why you get up in the morning and for some reason you still have a desire to stay with Jesus when other people left him. Por eso, despiertas con un deseo de permanecer con Jesús. Porque realmente eres una rama que está conectada a la vida. Porque estás adentro y Jesús está ahora en ese momento intercediendo por ti. Mira, guárdalos, Dios, de nuevo este día. Keep them another day, God. Make sure they're going to make it. I'd be gone if not for that. I promise. I wouldn't be a Christian. I'd leave. One, 7 a 12 presenta un problema con eso, porque los discípulos están pensando, ok, está bien, si el Padre va a guardarnos, ¿qué pasó a Judas? John 17, 12 presents you a little bit of a problem, because the disciples are thinking, well, if God's going to keep me, what happened to Judas? Look at what it says. Mira lo que dijo. Y mira, eso es algo que realmente es misterioso. Es algo que no podemos entender al fondo. This is something that you will not understand this side of heaven, and I don't think actually you'll ever understand it. And by you, I mean me. None of us, right? He says this, Juan 17, 12. Cuando estaba con ellos, los guardaba en tu nombre. When I was with them, I kept them in your name. El nombre que me diste, los guardé, y ninguno se perdió. I kept them in your name that you give me, and none of them has perished. Watch this now, because los discípulos están pensando, uno ha perdido. The disciples were saying, wait a second, one died. What happened to him? ¿Qué pasó a él? Listen. Jesús dijo, excepto el hijo de perdición, para que la escritura se cumpliera. He says, except the son of perdition, so that the scripture would be fulfilled. Dios no hizo a Judas de hacer lo que hizo. God did not make Judas do what he did. Judas decidió por su propia voluntad de hacerlo. Judas decided to do it of his own volition. Pero escúchame bien. Este versículo es en la Biblia para probar a los discípulos y nosotros que ninguna persona que realmente está en el rebaño de Jesús puede ser perdido. This verse is in the Bible to prove to you that nobody who's really in the flock of God can be lost. Why? Jesus is saying, I knew about it. Yo sabía de eso. Yo sabía lo que Judas haría. I knew what he would do. We've seen this, right? Listen in John 6, 7. It's Juan 6, 70. No los he escogido a ustedes 12, repuso Jesús. No obstante, uno de ustedes es un diablo. Jesus is talking to his disciples. He said, didn't I choose all of you? And yet one of you is a what? A devil. I knew it. I picked him. Yo lo escogí. Yo sabía lo que él haría. I knew what he would do. Mira, Jesús está diciendo, no, escúchame bien. Judas nunca era una oveja. Judas never, ever was a sheep. Porque no es posible pertenecer a Dios desde antes de la creación, ser dado a Jesús como un regalo de amor, recibir la revelación personal de Jesús, creer y después ser feliz. It is not possible for somebody who has always belonged to God, been given to Jesus, received the revelation of Jesus personally, believed, received, and understood to finally be lost. That is not possible. And Jesus is telling you that here. Él dice, al contrario, esa es la voluntad de que él me envió, Juan 6:38. This is John 6:38. Listen to this. This is the will of him who sent me, que yo no pierda nada de lo que él me ha dado, sino que lo resucite en el día final. He says, this is the will of him who sent me, that I lose nothing of all that he's given me, but I raise it up on the last day. Juan 10, 27-28, this is John 10:27-28. Mis ovejas oyen mi voz. My sheep hear my voice, y las conozco, y me siguen. I know them, and they follow me. Yo les doy vida eterna, y jamás perecerán. I give them eternal life. They will never perish. And listen to this. Nadie les arrebatará de mi mano. Nobody can snatch them out of my hand. Nobody. Why? Because they've always belonged to me. Cristiano, ¿sabe quién eres? Do you know who you are, Christian? Tal vez es la primera vez que tú has oído esto. Maybe this is the first time you've ever heard this. You just thought one day you were smart enough to decide and just make, I just figured it out. Tal vez un día pensabas que, mira, yo era suficientemente inteligente de hacer una decisión y esa persona... Él dice, yo no estoy en el mundo, ya no está en el mundo. Él dice, I'm not in the world anymore, pero ellos sí están en el mundo. Yo voy a ti, they're in the world and I'm going to you. Padre Santo, guárdalos en tu nombre. Holy Father, keep them in your name. El nombre que me has dado para que sean uno así como nosotros. El último punto. Keep them in your name so that they'll be one just like us. Here's the last thing. Jesús usa una comparación de la Trinidad para describir qué es ser cristiano. He uses a comparison Jesus does of the Trinity to show what it is to be a Christian. He says, here's what I want you to do, Father. Keep them one just like we are one. What's that mean? Jesus puts you in the Trinity. You're in the middle of the Trinity as a Christian. Jesús, lo que él está diciendo, para que sean uno como así nosotros somos uno, él está diciendo, ellos están adentro de nosotros como una Trinidad. Eso no significa que eres Dios, Christian. That doesn't mean you're God, okay? That means that what it means to be a Christian is that God puts you in the middle of the Trinity, and he says, keep them there. Don't let them get out. Let them be one with us. Mira, eso significa que ahora, cristiano, estás en unidad con la Trinidad en la comunidad de la Trinidad. This means, Christian, that you are in the middle of the unity of the community of the Trinity and you can't get out there. Because Jesus is going to keep you there. And listen, just so you know, era un teólogo, se llama Jonathan Edwards. There was this theologian named Jonathan Edwards, okay? He's a smart guy, okay? All right. Él pensaba de la Biblia que la Trinidad funciona algo así. This is, he thought, this is maybe how the Trinity works. Tú tienes el Padre y tú tienes el Hijo. Okay? El Hijo es la imagen del Padre. So, the Son is the image of the Father. El Padre se alegra en la imagen del mismo en el Hijo. The Father loves to see the delight of himself in the image of the Son. Y el Espíritu Santo está comunicando el amor del Padre al Hijo, Hijo al Padre, Padre al Hijo, Hijo al Padre. The Spirit is taking this love back and forth between the Son and the Father while they're looking on each other and having delight, infinite delight in one another. And God said, I'm going to take you and put you right in the middle of that. That's what heaven is. That's heaven. Associated. Para estar en medio de la Trinidad, para experimentar el amor del Espíritu Santo y, bueno, la deleite del Hijo al Padre y Padre al Hijo. Eso es cielo. That's what it means to be a Christian. Eso es lo que Jesús está orando. Guárdalos en esa unidad. Keep them in that unity. Una oración como ejemplo. This happened, actually. ¿Tú recuerdas cuando Simón o Pedro estaba en punto de negar a Jesús? You remember when Simon Peter was at the point of denying Jesus? Él dice que, well, what did he say? What did he say to Jesus before he denied him? ¿Qué dijo a Simón Pedro a Jesús antes de lo negó? Nunca. I'll never leave you, I'll never abandon you, and if everybody else leaves you, I'll never deny you. Right? Nunca voy a negar. No te preocupes, Jesús. Yo voy a estar contigo hasta el fin. No me importa qué pasa con los otros. Yo voy a estar contigo. I'm going to always be with you until the end. Here's what Jesus says back to him. Simón, Simón. Simon, Simon. This is Luke 22:31-32. Listen. Lucas 22:31-32. Simón, Simón, mira que Satanás ha pedido zarandearnos. Hey, Simon, Satan's asked to sift you like wheat. Simón, Simón, mire que Satanás ha pedido zarandearlos a ustedes como si fueran trigo, pero yo he orado por ti para que no falle tu fe. Listen to this. Simon's sitting there thinking he's strong, and Jesus comes up and says, Satan asked to sift you like wheat, but I prayed for you that your faith wouldn't fail. Eso es la única razón que Simón dio vueltas. Arrepintió y creyó de nuevo. That's the only reason that Simon Peter repented. Because Jesus said, I'm praying for you. Mira, la invitación a la gracia de Dios es gratis. The invitation to come this morning is free. Para los cristianos, la aplicación es estar seguro esta mañana, tener la seguridad, tener la confianza que realmente Dios te va a guardar en la fe. What you need to think about as a Christian is that God's going to keep you in the faith because of this chain we've been talking about all morning. Chose you, gave you to Jesus, revealed to you. You believed and He's saying, now I'm going to keep you forever. Cristiano necesita pensar que Dios te ha elegido, te ha dado a Jesús. Te ha revelado a Él personalmente a ti, tú has creído y por eso Él va a guardarte por medio de orar y interceder por ti por para siempre. But if you're not a Christian this morning, the door is thrown wide open. You say, how do I know if I'm a sheep? Come and believe. You say, I believe Jesus is the Christ. Good. You're a sheep. Praise God. Come to Jesus. Tú puedes venir esta mañana. Tú dices, ¿cómo sé que yo soy una oveja? ¿Crees? Y sabrás. Tú puedes creer esta mañana. La invitación es para todos en este cuarto. La invitación es gratis. Bueno, la Apocalipsis 22:17 dice, tú puedes venir porque el agua es gratis. You can come this morning, it's all free. So please, listen to me. Don't leave the room without a relationship with Jesus. No salgas de este cuarto sin una relación con Jesús, porque Jesús está aquí con brazos abiertos. Él está esperando. Él está listo. He's ready to receive you. Come to Him this morning. And you're like, I can get in on the Trinity this morning. Come to Him and you'll be in. It's free. It's free. So I'm going to pray for us. And then we'll be done. And voy a orar y después vamos a terminar con la gran comisión como siempre. Pero yo creo que es un momento especial que tenemos esta mañana. Yo quiero tomar un momentico para que meditemos en lo que Dios ha estado diciendo a usted. I just want to take a moment here to just pray. And you just see what God's been saying to you. Si Dios ha estado hablando a ti, por favor, no salgas sin hablar con Él y hacer lo que Él te está mandando. If God's been speaking to you, don't leave without dealing with Him. Please. Let's pray. Señor Jesús, esta vida cristiana es algo profunda, es algo increíble. Tal vez es la primera vez que una de las ovejas aquí ha oído la palabra de seguridad que tú tienes en este pasaje. Tal vez ellos han estado pensando, yo puedo llegar al cielo por mi propia fuerza, yo tengo que hacer algo para mantenerme, llevar algo. Ellos necesitan depender en tu poder, en tu gracia. Ellos necesitan dar cuenta de quién era, de quién son y quién serán. Señor, y para los que no han venido a Cristo, Señor, yo te pido, Señor, habla a ellos, ayúdales, abre sus corazones a ver la necesidad de Cristo, Señor. Abre sus ojos para recibir a Cristo por la primera vez y ver que la invitación es para todos. Ven, ven, ven. Atráelos, Padre, como solo tú puedes. Vamos a depender en ti. God, this morning, we're thankful for the fact that this Christian life is something amazing and incredible. And for Christians in the room who are always struggling with their assurance, would you help them to see that it's not about keeping themselves in the faith, it's about the fact that you've done that because they've always belonged to you, and they always will. And that you're doing what is necessary to keep them in unity with you. God, would you take unbelievers in the room and would you help them to see Revelation 22:17, the Spirit and the Bride say, come. Take the water of life freely. Would you open their hearts to see that, do that, and know that? God, we want to see lost people come home. We want to see prodigal sons return. We want to see lost coins found. We want to see lost sheep grabbed up and taken back into the fold. We want to see this broken, broken community. We want to see it turned upside down for Jesus. And so would you help us to take your word and unashamedly and with the conviction and power of the Spirit, help us to preach it to other people. And I pray that you would give us a new confidence in you that tonight, if tonight is our last night, and we're in you, there is not a way under heaven or in heaven that you will let us be lost. We take our refuge in that. And thank you for all that you've done, Jesus. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Mira, si necesitas hablar con alguien después sobre la relación con Cristo o algo, habla conmigo, con otros. If you need to talk to somebody afterwards, please talk to me or talk to somebody else. Why don't we stand up, and we don't have it up on the screen, but that's all right, we can quote it. Todo ponte de pie, no tenemos allá en la pantalla, pero vamos a citarlo. El problema, aprieta la mano de alguien. All right, who's got it? ¿Quién puede citar la Gran Comisión en español?
Ben.
Y Jesús se acercó a todos ellos y les dijo, se me ha dado toda la autoridad en el cielo y en la tierra. Por tanto, vayan y hagan discípulos de todas las naciones, bautizándolos en el nombre del Padre y del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo, enseñándoles a obedecer todo lo que les he mandado a ustedes, y les aseguro que estaré con ustedes siempre hasta el fin del mundo.
All right, Teresa en inglés.
Jesus.
Just came up and spoke with him, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age.
Yes!
Yes! Gracias por venir. Thanks for coming. I've got some work to do. Ridiculous. While we breathe.
Hey, give that back. All right, I gotta take that guitar seat out. I'll bring it back. I'm gonna go get it. Okay, I'll bring it.
$2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2 $2